Now, let's start exploring the Datasets tab. As mentioned before, here I am able to see all my added datasets into the Driverless AI platform. As a reminder, if you are using your own user account, and as long as you do not erase the instance, you will be able to access all your datasets at any time. For those using Aquarium, this is not an option, and all your assets will be erased after 2 hours. So, when connecting for the first time to the platform, the landing page is blank and there are no datasets. But you can add specific files by clicking on the Add Dataset button. Depending on the data source connections of your company, you might have access to different or additional options. In my case, I can add a dataset from a couple of sources, among which the file system, my own PC, Amazon S3, H2O Drive, Snowflake, the feature store, or a new URL address. Additionally, we can also have a data recipe to fetch any external data. Now, we will add our file by clicking on the Add Dataset button and selecting the Amazon S3 option. There is a new pop-up window appearing, and in order to have access to our H2O Amazon public repository, let's type data.h2o.ai after the two slashes. Then, please click on training/. There are, as for the moment of this recording, 29 matches found, and the file of interest to us is called credit_score.csv. Let's select it and add this file to our Datasets tab, then click on the button that appears on the top of the screen called Click to Import Selection. After a few seconds, we can see that the file has been successfully loaded and that it appears now on our Datasets page, presented in a row format with the following information: name of the dataset, path, size, number of rows, and we can observe that the file contains 100,000 rows in total. Column numbers. Here we can see that there are in total 26 columns or features. There is a status that we will be looking at soon, and date of creation. In case you have a lot of datasets in this tab, you can search a specific file by name or by date of creation in the search bar section underneath the dataset's title. Additionally, if you wish to delete a dataset, you can tick the square in front of the name of the file and click on the Delete One Item button. I will not do that, so I will unselect the dataset by clicking once again on the square in front of the name. Instead, let's learn more about our dataset.